Near the end of the last video, I wasn't as articulate as I would like to be, mainly because I think 15 minutes into a video, my brain starts to really warm up too much. But what I want to do is restate what I was trying to say. We got this confidence interval. We were confident. I'll rewrite it here. We're confident that there is a 95% chance, or I'll just say that we have a, I'll just restate the confidence interval. So there's the 95% confidence interval, 90% confidence interval for the mean of this distribution, confidence interval for the mean of that distribution. So the mean of that distribution we got as being 1.91. 1.91 plus or minus 1.21. And near the end of the video, I tried to explain why that is neat. Because you know, here we have it's a confidence interval for this weird mean of the difference between the sampling mean, the mean of the difference between the sampling mean. So it seems kind of confusing. But I just want to restate what we saw in previous videos. This thing right over here, the mean of the difference of the sampling means, the mean of the difference of the sampling means we saw two or three videos ago is the same thing as the mean of the difference of the means of the sampling distributions. So the difference of the means of the sampling distributions. And we know that the mean of each of the sampling distributions is actually the same as the mean of the population distributions. So this is the same thing as the mean of population 1 minus the mean of population 2. And this was the neat result about the last video. This isn't just a 95% confidence interval for this parameter right here. It's actually a 95% confidence interval for this parameter right here. And this is the parameter that we really care about. The true difference in weight loss between going on the diet, going on the low-fat diet, and not going on the low-fat diet. And we have a 95% confidence interval that difference is between 0.7 and 3.12 pounds, which tells us that we have a 95% confidence interval that you're definitely going to lose some weight. We're not 100% sure, but we have a 95, you know, we're 90, we're confident that there's a 95% probability of that. Anyway, hopefully that clarifies it a little bit. I didn't want to confuse you too much with kind of that bungled language that I had at the end of the last video.